watch out.
Her wedding was like the same thing.
Yeah. There was an archway over there. I think you heard that.
Whatever you want to call it. Yeah.
Never be on the radio.
I think we can do better though. Are we ready to start this party or what? Can we make some noise?
All right.
We got some music. That means we can start bringing people in. Are we ready? So first, we're gonna bring in the parents, so let's get some rounds of applause here. Let's hear it first for John and Terry Hocker. Right behind them is Leslie and Michael. It's the Kaniskis, everybody. Please, come on, let's hear it. All right. So we're ready to bring in the wedding party. First up, let's hear it for Justin McTish and Jess Aber. Right behind them, it's Keith Salmon and Liz Maglio. All right. Next up, let's hear for Dalton Landis and Morgan Hocker. Let's hear it from Mike Smirker and Michelle Wagner, everybody. All right, right behind them is Seth Workman and Kelsey Kaniski. All right, let's get a round of applause for the best man, Tyler Hacker, matron of honor, Maria Castles. All right, everybody, let's make the most noise we can possibly make. Are you ready? Let's bring him in, Mr. and Mrs. Luke Hacker! Make some noise, keep it going. Are we ready for the first dance, everybody? How about it?
Yesterday just came and went, and today dealt me another hand of heartaches that I played. What we said and what we meant, two different things, just some words and rings, and time keeps raising the stakes. My dreams, and tomorrow I wake up and have to feel you fade away. That's the way it goes, it seems. Tears filled with pain and they fall like rain, constant reminders every day. Without your love,
let's hear it. That's how you do it. Awesome. So, nobody go anywhere. It's time for a little father-daughter dance. How about it? All right, here we go.
Where it began, can't begin to know it, but then I know it's growing strong. Wasn't the spring, and spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Hand, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. So good. I've been inclined to believe that never was.
All right, come on, everybody. Let's hear it one more time. Wonderful. Fantastic participation there.
Amazing.
All right, so you know what that means. It's time for a little mother son. Give him a little more encouragement. Come on, some long walk. Let's hear it.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, tell me, why are you still so afraid? Where's the fire? What's the hurry about? You better cool it off before you burn it out. You got so much to do and only so many hours in a day. But you know that when the truth is told, that you can get what you want or you can just get old. You're gonna kick off before you even get halfway through. Ooh, when will you realize Vienna waits for you?
All right, everybody, let's get a big old round of applause. Let's
slow
hear it.
Down, you're doing fine. You can be everything you want.
Okay, so how's everybody feeling? Good. So we're going to get right into everything here. We're going to do some toasts. So we'll have everybody's attention right in the front. So first, I'm going to hand everybody this wireless mic. So let's make sure this thing is on. Everybody hear that okay?
Yeah.
Perfect. So first, we're going to call on the father of the bride, everybody. Let's hear it for Michael. Here, one more time, everybody. Come on, let's
go. I'm going to go to Arthur Murray right after this, please. Okay, good evening, everyone. Welcome to this wonderful celebration of marriage, family, faith, and life. Leslie and I offer our sincere appreciation to all of you for sharing the blessed marriage of Caroline and Luke today. Today is a triumph. We made it. Thank God. Today, we celebrate marriage, a beautiful wedding with a beautiful ceremony and a beautiful church. Thank God. Today, we celebrate families and our friends, safely traveling from all over the country. Thank God. Today we celebrate faith in the sacred vow of marriage. Thank God. Today we celebrate life. We are most thankful to be here today with all of you. Thank God. Leslie and I are thrilled for Caroline and Luke as they begin their life as husband and wife. A wonderful journey awaits them, one filled with purpose, challenges, and victories, along with love, laughter, and happiness. Having Caroline as our daughter has been a complete joy. Leslie and I enjoy both our daughters so much and have absolutely loved our 26 years together. Caroline and Maria are true ladies, thanks to Leslie. Luke was a true gentleman, asking Leslie and I for permission to marry Caroline. He proposed to Caroline at Sunset Beach with the entire family present. It was a magical moment. Caroline is joining a wonderful family. The Hacker family share the values of faith, family, honesty, hard work, and traditions. Caroline and Luke first met at Penn State Berks as freshmen. Leslie and I first thought that there might be something special in their relationship when Luke took Caroline to the Belmont Stakes for the final leg of the Triple Crown. They witnessed the first Triple Crown winner in 37 years. Luke wearing his green pants and bow tie and sports coat, and Caroline in her long blue dress and an oversized hat. Both were stunning. It has been said that opposites attract. Not the case with Luke and Caroline. Caroline and Luke have been very busy during their engagement. They both have been working hard at their careers, and they purchased their first home. They have spent many hours adding the special touches to make it their own. During these milestones in one's life, you often reflect. As I reflect on this beautiful occasion and the many blessings we have received in our lives, I especially want to thank Leslie. Ever since she was a little girl, she wanted to be a mom. She got her wish, and she is an incredible mom and wife. We embrace Luke becoming part of our family. Caroline and Luke make a wonderful couple. We pray that they will share a lifetime together with joy that grows deeper, hearts that grow closer, and love that grows stronger year after year. As stated in Corinthians 3, three things are forever: faith, hope, and love, and the greatest of these is love. Congratulations to Caroline and Luke. We love you both. Cheers.
We need another round of applause, everybody. Let's hear it one more time. So next, we're going to call on our matron of honor, everybody. Please, let's hear it for Maria.
Hi, everyone. I'm Maria, sister of the bride. First of all, thank you all for being here with us to celebrate the love of Luke and Caroline. I would like to thank my parents and Mr. and Mrs. Hacker for providing us with this unforgettable evening. It has honestly been the best day ever. It was not easy writing this speech because it was really hard to put into words how special my sister is to me. For 26 years, she's been my best friend and sister. Growing up, we did everything together. We made the best memories of all our years of dance and traveling the world and our family get-togethers. Caroline has followed in my footsteps for a lot of things, but I have to be honest, I've learned so much more from her. Caroline, you have taught me more than a few things. For example, I've learned so much about fashion from you. You always have the cutest outfits, and I like to steal them from you. I love the hairstyles that you come up with, and I always ask that you do it for me, too. And you are always so organized. Well, I could use a little help in that department if you have some time. You've always been there for me, and I would have been lost without the supportive sister that you've been. So thank you very much. And I am always there for you, too. Throughout the years, I've watched as Caroline grown into the strong, beautiful, and independent woman that she is today. Caroline is the most generous person who will happily go above and beyond for anybody in need. She demonstrates this through her event planning at the Milton Hershey Fellowship Girls. Care puts her heart and soul into every endeavor that she is faced with. Knowing her so well, I know that she'll do the same with her marriage. Luke, you are a lucky man. We all know how classy Caroline is, but I think that Luke might be the only person that I've met who is able to match her level of classiness. Trust me, it's not an easy task. I've been trying for years. So the first time I've heard of this Luke character was when Caroline was telling me about their first date. It was a double date, and I could tell that Caroline really liked him because she wanted everything to go smoothly. This was when I knew that Luke was different from the rest. So you can imagine the way Caroline felt when he didn't get her number on the first date. Luke, I know it was your biggest regret. Of course, Luke eventually got Kara's number and their relationship took off from there. The love that they have for each other always looked effortless and fun. These two are perfect for each other, and they are always in sync, almost too in sync. Let me explain. So one of the first times meeting Luke was at Penn State, and Caroline and I were getting coffee at Starbucks, and Luke was going to meet us there. Luke walks in, and he's literally wearing the same exact outfit as Caroline. A long sleeve white t-shirt with a navy blue vest. I did a double take because I couldn't believe my eyes. They just looked like a couple's advertisement from J.Crew. It was so funny, but I think Luke wanted to go home and change. It was on that day I fully understood how in sync they really were. And the funniest thing is, I don't think that was the only time that this happened before. Luke, you are the person for Caroline. You are so good to care, and you treat her with your hospitable southern charm. Plus, I've heard you make dinner and clean up, too. Kara might not be the best in the kitchen, but she sure can set a nice table. Luke, you are a gem. Just make sure you give Caroline a kiss goodnight before you give Duke one. Luke is the perfect for my sister. I've said it so many times in so many different situations. They just see eye to eye, and they get each other like no one else does. I love how they prioritize family and are so supportive of each other's career and long-term goals. I know that that will make for a happy married life. Luke, welcome to the family. Our family is now complete with you in it. Luke and Caroline, I can't be more happy for you two. May your love grow in this crazy and fun journey of marriage. Cheers to the bride and groom.
Come on, everybody. Proper round of applause. Big one. Let's hear it. Yay. That was really nice. Okay. Are we ready for the best man? Let's hear it for Tyler.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming tonight. I know some of you have traveled pretty far to be here. And I thank you to the Kaniskis for throwing such a beautiful wedding. For those of you who I haven't met yet, I'm Tyler, Luke's older brother and the best man. Some of you might not know this, especially on the Kaniski side, but for many years, I've actually called Luke by the nickname Buddy. It's a long story from one of Luke's childhood phases. I think he wanted to be a big game hunter or a farmer or something. I think we're all happy he changed his mind, especially you, Caroline. But for some reason, that nickname has stuck around. So if I accidentally call him Buddy tonight during this toast, sorry about that. And don't blame my parents. They gave him a normal biblical name, and I've screwed that up. My girlfriend Elise and I, we were talking the other day about how she remembers her parents bringing home her younger brother from the hospital for the first time, and all the emotions that come with meeting your baby sibling for the first time. And afterwards, I was thinking about what she said in this toast tonight, and I realized that I don't really actually remember a time without having a little brother. In my mind, we've sort of always been together from birth. I know when we were kids, we did everything as a pair, whether it was going to the skate park, or getting Pokemon for our Game Boys, or even having the same blonde bowl cut for like way too many years. And I know that we didn't always get along. There's always plenty of fighting and bickering, like the time that I punched you in the nose and you bled all over the bathroom floor, or that time that that my friends and I took the raft out of the fishing club and left you on the shore. So I know that being the little brother had to be rough sometimes, and I'm sorry about that. But every time we fought, or we did something, or I did something cruel as an older brother, I knew exactly what lecture was coming from both my mom and dad, but especially my mom. And I know that you remember it too. Our mom always used to say, repeatedly, sometimes for what seemed like hours, that there was no bond out there that was stronger than blood. And that even when your parents are gone, or your friends let you down, or times get tough, you can always count on family, and especially your siblings, to be there for you. And of course, she always made it very clear that both of us only had one sibling to get along with. I particularly remember getting that lecture on one of our many 10-hour drives down to North Carolina to visit family, when my mom refused to let us stop to use the bathroom, and instead had an empty Breyers ice cream tub on the floorboards in the back of the van. Of course, she was fanatical with keeping her cars clean, especially those old Mercury vans, so I was tasked with holding the ice cream tub steady while Luke emptied his bladder about what seemed like every half hour or so. Caroline, I really don't know who cleans the bathrooms in your house, but let's just say that I hope Luke's aim has improved a little. So, at the end of the day, it's probably just because I was getting my hands peed on, but that lesson has always stuck with me, that blood is the strongest bond out there, and that we would always be there for each other. And I think we've both found that to hold true over the years. Thanks, Mom and Dad. Unfortunately, I was in college or overseas for a few years when Luke was at Penn State and when he first met Caroline. I've always felt like I missed a lot during those years, from Luke's graduation to family events and, of course, the infamous hair-petting incident at Casey's wedding. I haven't seen him go for any in-laws' hair yet tonight, but the night is still young, so Caroline, please keep an eye on him. But, of course, while I was away, I heard about Caroline and Luke through my parents. I heard about Caroline from Luke and through my parents, but I don't think I really got to spend any time with her until they'd already been dating for some time. And by the time I really did get to know Caroline, her and Luke had graduated Penn State and they were both working. I have to say that as an older brother, who's used to having your little brother follow you around and do everything you do, there's nothing better and nothing that will make you more proud than coming back home after a few years and seeing your brother charting his own course, thriving in a career as an engineer, surrounded by a solid group of friends, and happy as can be in a relationship with a girl as wonderful as Caroline. Caroline, getting to know you over the last few years has truly been an honor. It's been amazing to see how happy you make Luke and how you both seem to bring out the best qualities in each other. My mom always said there was no bond thicker than blood, but I couldn't be happier to know that now Luke has someone who cares about him as much as I do. You really felt like a part of the family for a long time now, but now it's official. So welcome to the family. Everyone, please join me in raising your glass and congratulating the newly list. Cheers to Luke and Caroline.
All right, please, one more round of applause for Tyler. Good job. All right. Okay, so it's time for a blessing. Okay, so for that, we're going to call on the uncle of the bride. So let's hear it for Stephen Kaniski. Oh, he's right here. Oh, my God.
Our heads as we ask for God's blessing. We gather here to celebrate the love and commitment of Caroline and Luke as they share their first meal together as husband and wife. We thank you for giving your holy blessing today upon their marriage and ask that you continue to bless them with your love and mercy throughout their lives together. We thank you for their family, friends, and loved ones gathered here in your presence to celebrate their marriage. We ask for your holy blessing upon this meal and the hands that prepared it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Yes. Thank you. Okay, everybody, please enjoy dinner. As we do that, please let's get one more big round of applause for Caroline and Luke. Thank you, Stu, for having us over tonight. We'll catch up very soon.
You're nobody till somebody loves you.
Good skeleton. I'm gonna try to sneak it. night, everybody. The dance floor is open. Don't be shy. We will start easy. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. But this thing, called love, when it cries, but ain't a break my daddy swing.
Hell no.